Welcome. I'm Lenore Kulek, and this is Look Great, Feel Great, the Fitness, Health, and Beauty Show. I'm glad you could join me for the exercise and information to keep you looking and feeling your best. Today, let's do full body toning with weights, and we'll do also a segment on stretching to balance it out. So let's get started with feet apart, toes out. Let's breathe. And then circle the arms and bend the knees and keep it going. Breathe in and breathe out. And we always want to start with our breath. Release. And one more time. Okay, now let's get those hips moving. So we loosen up, stretch it up, and then forward and down. And out to the sides. Stretch it up and forward and down. And again to the sides. Stretch it up, forward and down. And out to the sides. And we'll stretch up, bring it forward and down. Okay, let's punch it out. Punch it across. Now punch up and over. Reach it up and over. Two, three, four, five, six. Four more. Okay, march arms out in a W and pull back and center. Pull back, center, back and center. Pull it back, bring it to center. Two more, back, center. Okay, hips side to side. I'm gonna do scissors, face level down to the waist level. Looking good. Keep it moving. And one more time. Okay, toes straight ahead and bend and stretch. Bend and come up on the toes. Remember on the squats, keep your weight back. Imagine you're sitting in a chair and then go up on your toes. So it's bend and stretch. Bend. Two more. Bend and stretch. Bend and stretch. Okay, march it out. Ready for knee lifts? Let's go. Lift those knees. Two. Now kicks, kick it out. One, two, four, six. Knee lifts, elbows back this time. Two, three, four, five, six. Kicks with arms up. Two, four, six. Okay, march it out. All right, hands on hips. Now let's take it to the right and center, left and center. Side, center, side and center, side, center. Four more, side, center, center, side and center. Okay, let's get the hips going again. Let's go with a hopscotch now. Curls with the hopscotch. Three, four, six. A front hopscotch, and I'm gonna tap the leg in front. Three, four, six. Back with curls, two, four, six, seven. Now in the front, front hopscotch, two, four, six. Okay, march it out. Feet apart, figure eight. So it's one, two, three, four, five, six, eight, nine, ten. Okay, now let's take it side to side. Three, four, six, seven, up and over, stretch it. Two, four, five, six, seven, around the front, stretch it out. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, up high, reach up. Two, four, five, six, seven, and march it out. Okay, let's do a nice easy hustle jog. So it's forward, two, three, clap, back, two, three. Two more. And back to the, one more time forward, then we'll go to the side. Okay, to the side. One, two, four, five, the other side. This time go to the side and circle out. Two. The other way, circle out. To the side, punch it out. The other way. Two. Okay, right foot, heel forward, toe back. Swing your arms. Flex. Point. Point. Flex. Point. Two more. left side, flex it forward, point it back, warming up the lower leg. Flex, point, flex, and point. Two more. Point. Okay, march it out. Feet apart, let's stretch down. So to the right, hold the stretch. Come to the center, and I'm gonna hold it with one hand on either thigh, stomach in and up, stretch it out. And the left side. Remember, you should only stretch once your muscles are warm. Otherwise, a cold muscle doesn't want to stretch too much. So your best bet is stretching when it's cold. When it's warm, I'm sorry, not when it's cold. And now to the center, forward, two, three, and to the left, one, two, three, and come up to the top, breathe. Bring it down, and let's march it out, and we'll breathe, and release. And one more, breathe, and release. Okay, let's get to that floor work. So come down on the floor, and you can work with or without weights, your choice. Okay, the first one, I'm gonna take one of my weights. I'm gonna start knees bent, hands in on the chest, head is down, breathe in. As you release, do a press and extend the legs to a pike. Breathe in, breathe out as you come up. Two, that's it, three. Now, if you really have problems lifting your head because it's straining your neck, use one hand to support the head. So we're coming up and down, up and down, and lift. However, to make the neck stronger, you will have to use it a little bit. Okay, bring the feet down and apart. Left hand now is supporting the head. Weight is in the right hand. Breathe as you release. Come across. Punch across. Imagine there's a target around the outside of your opposite leg, and you're reaching for that target. That's it. So you can feel this is arm, shoulder, chest, and also waistline. Okay, two more. All right, we're switching sides. So the opposite hand is behind the head. Breathe first and breathe out as you come across. And you can count the reps to know you're breathing properly. You can count out loud when you're supposed to be breathing out. So coming up would be four, five, six, seven, and one more. Okay, take your breath. I'm gonna take both weights. All right, arms out to the sides, feet are apart. Keep your head on the floor on this one. Breathe as you release. Lift the backside off the floor, head stays on the floor. And click the weights over your chest. Then bring it down, breathe in. And lift and click. So here we're working chest, arms, backside, and thighs. Four. Five. Six. Seven, and one more. Okay, now I'm gonna put one weight down. Extend the right arm and leg, and I'm gonna kick up and crunch. That's it, kick up and crunch. Now, if it's too hard to do this with a weight in your hand, then just take the weight off. You have to see what's right for your body. In some cases, the weight might be too much for you, in which case, don't use it. You make it harder by going to the weight, to a heavier weight, or to more reps. But you wanna start where you know you're going to be, it's gonna work for your body. Okay, let's switch sides. So now I'm supporting with the left side, or the right side of the left arm and leg are extended, and we'll kick up. Two. Take your time. Did you know that slower is actually harder? You could see if you do it slowly, it's harder to do. Feel this right in the abs. And one more. Okay, let's put the weights down and do a full body stretch. So arms overhead. I'm gonna flex the feet and do the full body stretch. Breathe, stretch, and let it go, relax. Okay, bend the knees, let's get the weights again. I'm gonna take one weight. Knees in, weights at the chest, and the elbows are bent. Breathe, and then crunch it up and down. Two, three, four. That's it, you're doing a great job. Five. Six. So now we're using the weight and gravity to work out here. Okay, feet apart. Weight in the right hand, left hand behind the head. Let's come across. And we know slower is better, so we're taking our time. Some people might be more comfortable working faster than I am or slower. See what works best for you. Always individualize it for your body. Okay, one more. And I take my breath, switch sides. Okay, here we go. Crunch it across. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven, and one more. Okay, let's put a weight in either hand. Elbows out. Take your breath. As you release your breath, lift up the backside. Notice the palms are facing out. I'm gonna click the weights together over my chest, not my face, and bring it down. So up and over and down. And three. Breathe out as we say four. Five. Six. Here the abdomen is getting a little chance to rest because we did two abdomens and now we're gonna do another one for the abdomen. And that's the one where we extend the arm and leg and kick up. That's it. Two. The head comes off the floor as you lift the arm and leg up. Five. Six. Breathe out as you say seven, and then one more. Okay. Head down. Let's switch sides. Support it with the other arm. Left arm and leg extended and crunch up and kick. That's it. Good. Two. Breathe out, three, four, five, six, seven, and one more time. Okay, I'm gonna put the weights down and let's stretch out, flex the feet, think long as you can, make your body tall, stretch out, and then let it go. Okay, let's do some Pilates. Bend the knees, hands behind the head, and we're going to do opposite elbow to knee. So come opposite elbow to knee. Now for some people that have a problem back, this might be too difficult. It may hurt your back. If you find that it hurts your back, try one leg at a time. Okay, so that's an easier version on your back. But for those that can, that's it. Let's pump it. Four more. Okay, then head on the floor. Bring your arms down to the sides and let's do the hip circles. So we're letting the abdominals rest to work for us the next time. Hip circles will work your backside and thighs. Hip circles, breathe. And now let's go in the other direction and around. Beautiful. Okay, and the next one, bring the knees in. Lift the arms up and then extend the legs. If you have a problem with your back, keep the knees bent. If not, keep them extended. And let's hold in this pike position as we pulse the arms. Remember to breathe. Keep the navel in towards the backbone. You want to keep it stuffed in best as you can. And just hold. If you have a real problem with your neck, use one hand to support it. Okay, to get out of this, knees in, head down. I'm going to cross at the ankles. And let's just rock side to side. Nice and easy, side to side. Okay, unhook, hands behind the head. Let's do a second set. So we're pumping opposite elbow to knee. Remember, if this doesn't work for you, try one leg at a time. If that also bothers you, just do some basic crunches. There we go. There we go. Four more. All right, let's let the abs rest. Feet apart, arms down at the side. Now let's circle it around. Circle around. Remember to breathe. Important to breathe when you work out. You need the oxygen anyway, so breathe. And now let's go in the other direction. Breathe and let's go to the other direction. That's it. Feel it backside and thighs. Okay, the next one, bring the knees in. Remember, you want the stomach so that the navel is in towards the backbone. Extend the arms, extend the legs. If your back bothers you, keep the knees bent. And let's just pulse the arms. That's it. Chin off the chest. Let's pulse it. Keep breathing. Important to breathe. Pulse it. And then to get out of it, bring your knees in, head to the floor, cross the legs in, and let's rock side to side.
Okay, unhook, and now let's roll to our side. I'm gonna take one weight, although I'm not using it for the first exercise. So lying on our side, bend the bottom leg, extend it, okay? And I'm gonna lift it up, foot flex, and take it forward and up. Now this feels different than if you've ever done this. This is, you'll feel it in a totally different area. It really gets the glutes very well. So let's take it, there we go, good. Beautiful. So you're touching forward and up, and forward and up. Two more, foot is flexed. And of course, keep breathing. Okay, now we'll take the leg out, and I'm gonna put a weight on it. Of course, weight is optional. Okay, in and out, up and down. In and out, up and down. That's it. Good. And it's in, out, up, down. Out, up, down. Let's do two more. This is like a two-in-one, because you're working in and out and then up and down. So you're getting a lot of muscle workout here. Okay, both legs out, take the top leg back. Weight in the inner thigh. Now these are for those that tell me my inner thigh needs work. Let's lift up. So these next two are for the inner thigh. Lift, take your time. Four, five, six, seven, and eight. Okay, bend the knee so that the feet are at a 90 degree angle, and I'm gonna keep the weight on the inner thigh here and lift the bottom leg up towards the top leg. Two. Three, four, that's it. Feel it on the inner thigh. Five, six, two more, seven, and eight. Beautiful. Okay, we wanna do the same thing on the other side. So let's come up, we'll shake it out. Good job. Let's go to the other side. Okay, I'm keeping the weight nearby, but as you know, we're not using it till the second exercise. So get down, so you're supporting your head, bottom leg is bent. Extend the top leg, take it in front, and lift up. In front, and lift, good. Can you really feel it in there, those glutes? It's glutes, hip, side of thigh. You can really feel it, I can. Okay, so forward and up. Forward, one more time. Then bring it down, weight on the leg. Breathe, and then breathe out as we come in and out and up and down. In, out, up, down. In, out, up, down. In, out, up, down. Two more. Beautiful. Okay, both legs out. Take your top leg back and put the weight on the bottom leg. And we're going to lift it. Simple, just lift up and down. That's it. Foot is flexed. Four, five, six, seven. Okay, now that one, if you remember where we bent the knee, weight is on that inner thigh again, and lift the bottom leg towards the top leg. Two, three, four, five, six, two more, seven, and eight. Beautiful. Okay, let's come up and shake it out. And we're gonna fade this music out because we're going to do some stretches. So I'm gonna put the weights to the side. Okay, and let's sit tall, and we're going to stretch, but let's take a deep breath first, some deep breaths. Breathe, we wanna get a lot of stretching in too. And again, breathe in. And turn away, good. And then let's come around, circle around. And around. So lots of stretches. That's how you keep the body balanced. You tighten and tone, and then you stretch. And then breathe, and let's go the other way. And around. That's it. And we could always imagine that we're in a garden, beautiful garden. Okay, let's take the right hand close to the body. Stretch the left one over, hold. Let's come to the center, breathe. And then we'll stretch over the other way. And hold. Breathe. Stretch over, hold. And it feels good to stretch after you've toned. Breathe, and we'll stretch over one more time the other way. Okay, sit tall. Let's hug a tree, a big oak tree. So hold it in front. Breathe, and as you release, take that tree and bring it over to the right. Hold. Then breathe and take it over to the left. And hold. And breathe and come to center. Bring the arms down and let's take the right leg out, keeping the left leg in, and stretch to the toe and the other arm over the head. And we're all put together differently, so stretch as far as your body lets you stretch. If you feel pain, you know you're stretching too far. So pull back a little bit. But let's hold, come back to the center, and now let's take it out on the other side and bring one leg in, and it's left arm to the left leg, the right arm goes over. Stretch how your body is comfortable. Make the routine work for you. And hold. Come to the center. Interlock fingers while we're in straddle position. And leaning forward from the hips, we'll stretch forward. And then stretch it to the right. Hold. Breathe, and then we'll stretch over to the left. And hold. Okay, let's come to the center. Bring it in, and let's bring the legs in. Arms out with palms forward. Breathe, and as you release, turn it back and forth. And back and forth. Sit tall, breathe. Again, imagine you're in a wonderful place. It can't hurt to use a little guided imagery while you do your stretching. Two more. And back and forth. And back and forth. Take the right hand to the left ear. Push down on the left side. Breathe, and as you release, assist the stretch to the right as you push down on the left. Feel it stretching the muscles in the neck and shoulders. It also helps the range of motion for your neck joint. And hold. Breathe, and let's go the other way. And stretch. And again, once more to the right. Breathe and stretch. And now the other way. Breathe and let's stretch. Okay, come to center. Bring your elbow up as if you were washing your back with a brush and take the other hand underneath. And then hold your head tall. Hold the posture. Feel it in the shoulder girdle. Hold it. If you can touch the hands together, you get extra credit. Okay, let's release. And now let's go the other way. Left hand up, right hand under. Again, see if you could try to touch the hands. Head is tall once you're in position. Hold. And then release, shake it out. Let's come onto our back and do some stretches. Okay, lying back. Extend the right arm and leg. And stretch. And then release. Let's do the left arm and leg and stretch. Stretching out, reach. Hold, hold the stretch. Release, and let's do that full body stretch again. Full body stretch. Hold it, it feels good. And then relax it. Okay, let's bend the knees one at a time. Cross your right leg over the left. And I'm gonna take my hand, the right hand to that side. And I'm gonna bring the legs to the left, assisting it over while the other arm goes out to the side and the face turns in the other direction. So you can feel the stretch in the torso. Let's come to the center. Breathe and unhook, and let's go to the other side. And this time use your left hand and stretch it over only as far as it'll go. And the right arm and the face are on the right side, and hold. Hold the stretch. Okay, let's come to the center. Unhook. Hug the right knee into the chest and take the left leg out along the floor. This is good for your back. Point the toe up, hold. For a healthy back, you need to keep the back muscles flexible and the hamstrings and the abs strong. And we already worked on the abs. Okay, breathe as we bring the knee to the chest. Hold on to the left knee and extend the right leg out. Point the toe up, hold. Then bring both knees into the chest, cross at the ankles, and let's gently rock side to side. Okay, unhook. Place the feet down, the arms come overhead. Breathe, and as you release, bring your knees to the right. Hold. then bring the knees to the left. Release the breath as we stretch. Stretching feels good. Come to the center, breathe, and as you release, extend the right leg. They call this one the paradise stretch. And stretch it out. And now let's bring it back and stretch out the left leg. Toe points up, stretch. Okay, breathe, and as you release, bring the knees both bent. Okay, let's roll to the side. Come slowly, use your hands to come up. And let's again sit in the tailor, what's called tailor sit, or however you're comfortable. And let's sit with the palms facing up, shoulders are down. And let's take the right shoulder back twice, then the left, then the back, right shoulder forward twice, then the left. And now let's lift the shoulders up, breathe, let them go. Instant relaxation. Lift up, breathe. Let them go. Let your breath go, let the stress go with it. Lift up, breathe. Let it go. And one more time. Let's lift up, breathe. And let it go. Okay, and again, let's circle around. Leaning from the hips. Round. And then lift up to breathe. And release. Shake it out. Well, that was lovely. My fitness tip is remember not to bounce on your stretches. Stretches should be sustained and held. Until the next time, this is Lenore Kulek saying, be your best, be fit.